Good morning. Welcome back in your EVS class. How are you all children? Are you all fine? Yes, very good. I'm also fine and again I came back with you with a new video, with a new chapter to begin this in this video. Okay, so I hope you all are fine, right? Yes, you all are fine. Okay. So now children, you know that today I have come with a new video and with a new chapter. So do you think or do you can tell me anyone that which chapter we are going to start today in this video? Come on, tell me. Yes, very correct. A new chapter. Today in this video I'm going to start chapter number 7. Okay, chapter number 7, and this is the first video of chapter number 7. Okay, so before starting this chapter, before beginning this chapter, I'm going to say that already we have done till chapter number 6, water, in the previous video. And today I'm going to start a very new chapter, but I will not tell you the chapter name now, children. You all will guess what is the name of the chapter. But by guessing the name of the chapter, I will give you some clues, okay? So are you all ready? Come on, sit near the camera and listen to my things, what I'm going to explain and tell you, okay? For and after guessing it, you will come to know what is the name of the chapter. Yes, okay, let's begin. So children, today I am going to talk about a very new thing, and this thing is very important for us. Very important for us. Like water, this thing is also very important for us. Can any guesses? No? Okay, some clues. When you go out in a windy day, okay, when you go out in a windy day, what do you feel in your skin, and what do you feel? What do you can see in your hair, comes on? Yes? You feel very airy, na? Yes, the wind blows when you go outside in the windy days. So what is that wind called? That moving wind? Yes, air, correct. When you're standing, when you're feeling very hot, when you come out when in a hot summer season, when you go out for any work and when you come back to your home, what do you feel to have? Fan, right? So what the fan gives us? Air, correct. So children, the name of the topic which we are going to study today is air. Air is our 7th chapter, and this is the first video of chapter number 7, air. Okay, so can anyone tell me what is air? What is air? Can anyone tell me? Alright, let me give a clue. Okay, let me give a clue. There is air all around us. Okay, all around there is air. All living things need air to live. Without air, we cannot live. Okay, so air is present all around us, and without air, we cannot live. Okay, children, so they're thinking, you are thinking that where is air? You are thinking, now where is air? I cannot see any air. Is it hiding somewhere? No, it is not hiding, children. Then where are you, air? You were thinking, where are you, air? Air is everywhere. Air is everywhere. It fills your house. It fills your cars. It fills the empty glass. Yes, it fills your house. It fills your cars and it fills your empty glass. Okay, so you cannot see the air. Children, listen very carefully. You cannot see the air, but you can feel the air. Yes, you cannot see or touch the air, but you can feel the air. How you will feel the air? With the skin. You will feel the air with the skin. So let me give some examples of air so that you can understand very easily. Okay, now everyone will do with me. Everyone will do with me what I'm telling you to do. Okay, come on everyone, this hand, keep it in front of your mouth. Come on everyone, keep the hand in front of your mouth like this, how I have kept. And now you blow the air. Now you blow on the hand. You blow it like this. How I am doing? Keep the hand in front of your mouth and you blow on your hand. Do you observe something? What you have observed? Tell me. You can feel the air from the mouth on your hand? Yes, you can do it. You will try again and again. Keep the hand on your mouth, then blow it. You can observe the air coming out from the mouth on your hand. Yes, this is the example of air. One more example, children. If there is a working table fan, you know, not table fan. If there is a working table fan, you have on the fan and you are standing in front of a fan, what do you observe? How do you feel? You will feel that you are getting air from the fan on your face, right? When you are keeping a table fan in front of you and you on that fan, what will you observe or what do you feel? You will feel that the air is coming and you are getting on your face. So that is air. Okay, the next example is that if you take a hand fan, see, this is a hand fan. Yes, all of you now having a hand fan. So if I'm taking this hand fan in front of me and I'm feeling very hot and there is no electricity, there is no electricity, children. Okay, so if I'm feeling very hot, so what I will take or what I will do to get air? I will, yes children, I will fan out myself to get the air. I will fan myself to get the air. Okay, so children, I want to say that air is all around us. Without air we cannot live. All human beings like birds, animals, bee, okay, human beings, plants, and all the living things need air. We cannot live without air. Air is very, very, very important for us. Yes, air is very important for us. Listen, children. All living things need air to breathe. In fact, we human beings also need air to breathe. And they all breathe in and they all breathe out. Yes, we all breathe in and we all breathe out. You all do, na? Come on, do with me. You are breathing in and breathing out. So for how you are doing this? With the help of the air. We all are doing with the air. Okay, now children, I want to say that all living things need air. So I am going to say that when you are going out on the hot day, on a summer day, and when you are coming back at home, if you on the fan, what do you feel? You will feel the fresh air from the fan. You will get very cool air. Yes, you will get very cool air from the fan. And you will also feel sleepy. Yes, you also feel sleepy that I'm getting so fresh air and I want to sleep. Yes, so now, and you can feel the air from the skin. How you will feel it? You will feel this air from with the help of the skin. So, and now what happened, children, when you stand out in a windy day? Have you all gone out on the windy day? Yes. So when you're going out on the windy day, what do you observe or what do you find? That the wind blows. Yes, the wind blows and your hairs are blows with the wind. When you are running here and there, the hair is also blowing with the wind. Okay, and that is all air. The wind blows your hair. The wind blows your hair when you are running here and there on the windy day. Okay, so are you getting my point that what is air? Air is all around us. All living things need air. And children, Have you observed that on the windy day, when there is a lot of wind outside the house, the bushes of the trees are also swaying as the wind blows? Have you seen that? Yes, I have seen. Have you all seen that? What you have seen? That the bushes of the trees are also swaying as the wind blows. Yes? And that's right. Why it happens? Because the wind is the air that moves all around. Because wind is air that moves around. Well, wind is the only air that moving all around. Okay, what I'm going to say is that we cannot see air, we cannot touch the air, but we can feel the air. With the help of our skin, we can feel the air. If you're sitting in the air conditioned room and the air conditioner is giving you which air, hot or cool air? Cool air. So what do you feel? How you will feel it? With the skin, because it's giving you cool air. And when you're going out or moving in a car, you want to go somewhere and you're moving in a car and you put your head near the window. When the car is moving, what do you observe? That the air is also moving. The air is coming on your face and the hair is also moving with the help of the air. Yes? So air is all around us. All living things need air. We cannot live without air, children. Like water, air is also very important for us. Have you got my point? Now come on, everyone, take out your EVS course book. We will have a read from the chapter, and also you will take out, be ready with your EVS copy for the classwork as well as the